Good morning students. Hope all are fine. Today I am going to explain your lesson number 5, lines and angles. Already we have learned about the lines and line segment ratios. Okay, then first line. What is line? Line is a collection of points going endlessly in both directions in a straight line is called the line. A collection of points going endlessly in both directions in a straight line is called the line. And next one is the line segment. A part of a line with two end points is called the line segment. Symbolically, the line segment PQ is represented as PQ. Okay, what is a line segment? A part of a line with two end points is called a line segment. The one is symbolically line segment PQ is represented as line P. Okay, line segment P. And this is the ray. A part of a line with one end point going endlessly in one direction is called a ray. What is the ray? A part of a line with one end point going endlessly in one direction is called a ray. The symbolically is represented as ray XY is represented as ray XY. And next is the angle. Okay, in angle, when two rays originated from a common point, an angle is formed. An angle is measured in degrees. Symbolically, it is represented as angle. Okay, when a two rays, this one ray, this two rays originated from a common point, angle is formed. You know the types of angles. The first one is the right angles. An angle whose measure is 90 degree is called the right angle. An angle whose measure is 90 degree is called the right angle. And next one is acute angle. An angle whose measure is less than 90 degree is called the acute. And next one is the obtuse angle. Obtuse angle means an angle whose measure is greater than 90 degree but less than 180 degree. An angle whose measure is greater than 90 degree but less than 180 degree is called an obtuse angle. And next one is the straight angle. Straight angle which is more than a right angle. 180. And next is linear pair. A linear pair is a pair of adjacent angles whose non-common sides are opposite rays. The sum of linear pair of angles is 180 degree. Okay. A linear pair is a pair of adjacent angles whose non-common sides are opposite rays. The sum of linear pair of angle is 180 degree. Okay. Then angle A, B, P. Angle A, B, Q. Angle A, B, P and A, B, Q form a linear pair. Okay. This is the linear pair. Angle A, B, P plus A, B, P plus A, B, Q is equal to 180 degree. And next one is a adjacent angle. If two angles have a common vertex, a common arm and have the non-common arm on either side of the common arm, then they are called the adjacent angles. If two angles have a common vertex, this is A, B, D is one angle. D, B, C is one angle. The common, okay, the common vertex is the complementary angle when the sum of the measures of two angles is 90 degree, the angles are called the complementary angles. And next one is the supplementary angles. Supplementary angles means when the sum of the measure of the two angles is 180 degree, the angles are called the supplementary angles. What is the complementary angle? When the sum of the measure of two angles is 90 degree. So, supplementary